Oxygen Station on Space to Ground.
Thanks for joining us for Space to Ground. I'm Nicole Cloutier-Lemasters. Cosmonauts Sergei Rozanski and Oleg Kotov completed a six-hour spacewalk on Monday to install two new high-fidelity cameras on the exterior of the space station. The stunning views that you're seeing here came from the small cameras worn on the spacewalkers' wrists as they work 260 miles above the Earth. While outside, the pair also retrieved a Russian experiment that exposes different materials to the space environment. Inside the ISS, flight engineers Mike Hopkins and Koichi Wakata worked on a sensor that's part of ISERV, a small telescope that's mounted in the station's U.S. laboratory. When it's running, ISERV captures 3 Earth images per second. The goal of the experiment is to improve automatic image capturing and data transfer, but the images taken could also help environmental scientists, disaster responders, and other Earth-based users to understand environmental impacts from natural and man-made disasters. Hopkins also spent some time with the station's state-of-the-art microscope facility. This instrument enables new research of microscopic phenomena in microgravity. The way matter is organized and moves on the microscopic level affects everything around us, and understanding these detailed processes helps scientists and engineers build more efficient materials and machines for both the Earth and space environments. This week, we have a fantastic question from @JDPowell33. He asks, what is the livable volume on the space station? Many people are amazed to learn how big the ISS really is. There's actually more livable space on board the station than there is in a 6-bedroom house, 13,000 cubic feet to be exact. There's plenty of room, including 2 bathrooms, a workout area, and even an expansive bay window to enjoy that stellar view. Astronauts frequently say that sometimes they can work all day without seeing their crewmates. We always love to hear from you. Send us your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you again next week.